हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई विश यू वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम बैक आवर ऑनलाइन क्लास मैथ्स 8th स्टैंडर्ड। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू आवर 13th चैप्टर, दैट इज द कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट। इन द लास्ट वीडियो ऑलरेडी यू हैव स्टडीड, ऑलरेडी यू हैव गेट दैट नॉलेज, ऑलरेडी यू हैव लर्न दैट हाउ टू फाइंड आउट दैट सिंपल इंटरेस्ट एज वेल एज how to find out that compound interest by annually. Yes, that is by every terms, by the conversion periods are fixed, and every one year like that we are finding. But students, today we will find out that compound interest will calculated quarterly. That means the conversion period is 3 months. Okay, if it has given the rate of interest per annum, then per year, then we have to find out that conversion period, that is the 3 months. That means per year that it will be 4 times we have to calculate the interest, and whatever the interest we are calculated, that will add to the principal. Every instant that you will go as a principal, we have to see. So let us see, students, how to find out that compound interest if it has come, that interest will be calculated quarterly. So first of all, read that question thoroughly, students. Find the compound interest. CI matlab, what is that? Compound interest on 6000. Okay, it has given that principal 6000 per 1 year. For 1 year, for that we have to find out that, already I have told, the time period should be fixed on that while you are finding compound interest. Okay, so at the rate of 16% per annum. Okay, how much percent? That 16%, right? Rate of percent per yearly, that is the 16%. Okay, but you have to find out that quarterly. Okay, so we can write, given that principal, how much that principal given 6000 rupees. Yes, okay. So now rate of interest, rate of interest is equal to how much? 16% is given, and we have to find out that quarterly, time given for 1 year. Okay, so time is equal to 1 year. But understand, students, the rate of interest given 16%. Yes, but whenever we are finding that quarterly, what is that rate of interest? So it will become, it is per annum. This is per annum. Okay, so now, or we can write, if 16%, we can write 16% by 4% or is equal to 4% per quarterly. Okay, if the rate of interest also we can find out 4% per quarterly, same 16% per annum is equal to the 4% per quarterly. Okay, so now students, observe that we can write down that, what is that, we can write interest for the first quarter. Okay, so is equal to how much? So we have to find out first what is the principal, no change. Okay, here first time, and we can write 6000. What is the rate of interest? And the rate of interest is equal to 4%, that is fixed also, so always it will be 4%. And time is equal to, sorry, here first we PT, T matlab 1 we can write, because first quarter we are finding, so 1 we have to write, and rate of interest we have to write 4. So divided by how much? 100. Divided by 100. So first interest you have to find out. Whenever the 3 months it will completed, that means the conversion period is here 3 months, because 1 year total time, and it is given compound interest find out by quarterly. So that means 3 months we have to calculate. So first quarterly means 1 you have to multiply. If we'll cut this, if we'll cancel that 0000, the answer remain 6 4 240 rupees it will be. Okay, So now, whatever that interest will come, that it will be added for that principal. Okay. So now amount will be, so we can write amount at the end of, at the end of first quarter is equal to how much? How much it will come that first at the end of the first quarter? Now is equal to principal how much? 6000 plus 240 is equal to 6240 rupees amount. Whatever that amount did you get, that how we should make it as a principal. Okay, so hence the principal for the second quarter, for the second quarter is equal to how much? 6240 rupees. This is the principal for the second quarter. Okay, what the rate of interest? Same 4% is, and a time 1 year. Okay, so now you should observe that what is that interest for the interest at the end of, at the end of second quarter, how much will come? The principal we have to PTR by 100, you have to do interest we are finding. So PTR means principal, how much wins? 6240. What the time? Time always 1 we have to write. Rate of interest 4 divided by 100. Okay. So now you can 4 25 we can cut, and now we can divide here 6240 divided by 25. So 25 1 ja 25 12 7 12 and sorry, we can do that 2 ja, we can do no 2 ja 50 is equal to 2 here 12 124. So 20 we can do 4 ja 100 4 2 and 0 240 20 25 9 ja 225 5 here 3 15 point we can keep here 0 25 6 ja 150 is equal to 0. Okay, so we got 249 rupees 60 paise. So if we'll cut this, answer will come 249 rupees 60 paise. Okay, this is the interest. So what is that amount? Now look at here students, we can find out the amount at the end of second quarter. What is that amount? Now principal how much? 6240 plus 249 this. Okay, if we'll add 6240 249.60, if you add 60984, so we will get 6489 rupees 60 paise. This is the amount. So students, what is that principal for the, what is the principal for the third quarter? Okay, we can write now. Hence the principal I will write here. So principal for the third quarter is equal to how much? Principal is equal to the amount is equal to how much? That is the third quarter. So we can write 6489.60. okay, this is the principal. Now we have to find out that interest for the एंड ऑफ इंटरेस्ट फॉर द एंड ऑफ थर्ड क्वार्टर, ठीक है, थर्ड क्वार्टर हाउ मच विल कम, प्रिंसिपल हाउ मच 6489.60, टाइम 1, रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट 4 डिवाइडेड बाय हाउ मच 100, ओके, इफ इज 100 वी कैन इजीली वन टेक्निक यू शुड फॉलो, यू 4 विथ यू शुड मल्टीप्लाई, हाउ मच विल कम, वी कैन डायरेक्ट वी कैन डू, यस, सो if we'll do this we'll get, if decimal if we'll divide this how much will come, you should multiply first multiply then we can make it a decimal, so 0 4 6 24, 2 4 9 36, 38, 3 4 8 32, 32 3, 35 4 4 16 16 3 19 1 4 6 24 1 25, okay, so we can put that decimal where, we can put here, okay, now by 100, so now is equal to, if 100 then we'll get 259.580, okay, so we can write that much. So now students, what is that amount we will get? The amount for the at the end of amount at the end of third quarter, how much will come? Principal 6489.60 plus 259.58. We have to add. Okay. So if we add, we'll get 6489.60 259.58. If we add 6749.18 rupees, okay, so this is the amount, okay students, so now we'll get what is that, same procedure how like you have done the first instance, second and third, same like you have to find out again fourth, okay, so what is that principal, so principal also will get 6749.18 for the fourth quarter, okay, so now interest, so interest also rate of interest is equal to 4% now, so interest for at the end of fourth quarter, how much will get, now principal 6749.18 into 1 into 4 by how much 100, okay, same procedure we can do students, shall I rub it this side, okay, now I will rub it, we can do this raw problem, now look at here, we can do this 7049.18 into 4, first we can multiply by 4, 4 8 72, 7 we can write 72, 4 9 36, 3, 4 4 16, 16 3 19, carry 1, 4 7 28, 28 29, 2, 4 6 24, 2 26, okay, how much you got, 266, we can put here decimal, we can write 266 269 9672 here point by 100. Okay, so now if by 100 we can write it, decimal number will come to here, so 269.97 we can write direct. Okay, so what is that amount? The amount, okay, so now what is that amount we will get? The amount at the end of fourth quarter is equal to, how much will get? We can get last, we can write is 6749.18 plus 269.97. If you add 6749.18 269.97, 8, 7, 15 carry 1, 9, 10, 11 carry 1, 10, 19 carry 1, 11 carry 1, 0, 7,019 rupees 50 paise. This is the amount, okay, at the end of the fourth quarter. So what is that compound interest? So compound interest is equal to amount minus original principal. Amount how much? 7,019 rupees 15 paise minus principal is how much, students? We have taken that principal is 6,000. So if we'll subtract, how much will get? Now 1,019 rupees 50 paise will get that compound interest. Did you understand, students? So that means it has given quarterly. So for the conversion period, that means conversion period is 3 months. So 4 times you have to solve. We have to find out that interest, and whatever the interest will come, that you have to add it to that principal. Okay. And finally, you have to subtract the amount minus original. Original principal, then we'll get that compound interest. Okay, students. So now, students, we can do this. Our exercise part. What is that exercise part? Once I will explain. So question number exercise 13.1 we should do, and question number 4 I will same as it, I will do one another one. Find the compound interest on the sum 12,000. At the rate of 8% per annum for 1 year, compounded quarterly. Same as it question, students, once I will do here. Okay. Principal given, how much, students? 12,000. Okay. And a rate of interest given 8%, that means we can write it is quarterly, so divided by 4. It is per annum, or we can write 8 by 4 is equal to 2% per quarterly. Okay, understand, students? So 1 year given, that means 4 times you have to find out quarterly means. So interest for first quarter. Okay. So what is that PTR by 100? PTR, how much PTR? Principal 12,000 time 1, rate of interest how much? 2 by 100. So is equal to 0000 cancel. If we'll do 120, that means 240 rupees we'll get that. What is that interest? Okay, so now amount at the end of first quarter. How much got that amount of first quarter? Me? Now we have to add that 12,000 plus 240 rupees is equal to 12,240 rupees. This is we are getting amount for the at the end of that first quarter. Now we have to go for that same. This amount will become principal for the second quarter. Yaad rakho, whatever that amount we got, same here principal how much? Original principal. But now this will become as a, what is that principal for the second quarter? So principal for the डायरेक्ट आई लाइट सेकेंड क्वार्टर हाउ मच विल गेट 12,240 रुपीज. ओके सो नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट दैट इंटरेस्ट अगेन. सो इंटरेस्ट एट द एंड ऑफ सेकेंड क्वार्टर हाउ लाइक हाउ मच विल फाइंड आउट प्रिंसिपल इन टू टाइम इन टू रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. सो प्रिंसिपल 12,240 रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट ए टाइम वन रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट टू बाय हाउ मच 100. सो बाय डायरेक्ट यू शुड मल्टीप्लाई टू विथ 0 टू 4 जा 8 टू 2 जा 4 टू 2 जा 4 2 डिवाइडेड बाय 100 इज इक्वल टू 244.80. दिस इज द इंटरेस्ट. सो व्हाट इज दैट अमाउंट अमाउंट एट द एंड ऑफ सेकेंड क्वार्टर इज इक्वल टू प्रिंसिपल हाउ मच 12,240 प्लस 244.80 सो इज इक्वल टू 1200 ये 200 ये 200 मींस 400 1200 ये 200 4 84.80 दिस इज आर द अमाउंट. सो हेंस प्रिंसिपल फॉर द 3rd क्वार्टर हाउ मच विल कम 3rd क्वार्टर इज इक्वल टू वी गॉट 12,484.80. ठीक है नाउ स्टूडेंट्स ऑब्जर्व. सो वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट दैट इंटरेस्ट फॉर द 3rd क्वार्टर. यस सो इंटरेस्ट एट द एंड ऑफ 3rd क्वार्टर हाउ मच विल कम 12,484.80 इंटू 1 इंटू 2 बाई 100 सेम फॉर्मूला पीटीआर बाई 100 फॉर्मूला. नाउ इफ विल मल्टीप्लाई दिस टू रे मल्टीप्लाई यू शुड डू इज यू फॉर यू विल कम. सो 0 2 8 जा 16 कैरी 1 2 4 जा 8 1 9 2 8 जा 16 कैरी 1 2 4 जा 8 1 9 2 2 जा 2 2 जा 4 2 1 जा 2 बाय 100 ये दिस ऑलरेडी वी कैन पुट हियर. नाउ इज इक्वल टू इफ दिस मान विल कम टू हियर सो 249.69. ओके सो नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन फ्रेंड्स. नाउ व्हाट इज दैट अमाउंट अमाउंट एट द एंड ऑफ व्हाट इज द अमाउंट नाउ अमाउंट एट द एंड ऑफ 3rd क्वार्टर इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल यू शुड राइट डाउन प्रिंसिपल 12,484.80 प्लस 249.69 इफ विल ऐड 12,484.80 नेक्स्ट 249.69 12,734 रुपीज 12,734.49 पैसे. ओके सो नाउ फ्रेंड्स वी हैव टू दिस इज द प्रिंसिपल फॉर द 4th क्वार्टर. ठीक है सो यू शुड फाइंड आउट दैट प्रिंसिपल इज इक्वल टू 12,734.49. ओके सो व्हाट इज दैट इंटरेस्ट इंटरेस्ट इज इक्वल डायरेक्टली आई एम फाइंडिंग स्टूडेंट्स 12,734.49 इंटू 1 इंटू 2 by same 100 is equal to, if we multiply 1273449 into 2, we'll get 2546898 if we'll 2 plus here by 100. Okay, so and this if we'll simplify we'll get decimal place here, so 254.68 or 69 we can get approximately. Okay, we can write approximately 69. So now what is that amount? The amount is equal to principal 1273449 plus 254.69. If we add, how much will get? 12734.49 254.69. $12,989.18. Okay, this will get as a amount. What is that compound interest? Compound interest is equal to amount minus principal. Amount is equal to 12,989.18 minus 12,000. So 989. This is our compound interest. Okay, students, I hope you have understood about that. What is that compound interest and how to find out by using quarterly. And for you homework also, students, exercise 13.1 remain bits you have to do. Okay, students, thank you.